All right, so my name's Lieutenant Colonel Sonny Avichal. I'm the commander of the Nashville District, U.S. Army Corps of Engineers, and I'll go into a little bit more about kind of what that means or what that means in terms of area and kind of responsibility. I've been in the military for just over 18 years from Atlantic City, New Jersey. I graduated from West Point in 2002. I'm a PE in the state of Virginia. All right, so, you know, this is a slide that really at the end of the day, hopefully you all, if you have any interest of doing business for the government or you know, if you're in an industry right now that wants to do business with the government in the future, just a couple tips here. So be sure that you're registered on the System of Award Management, SAM. You can look for business opportunities. We always have to, by law, we have to post them through, used to be called Fed BizOps, now it's beta.sam. But that's where all of our projects are listed. And in it, it gives a lot of detail about what exactly it is that we're looking for. Solicitation packages. This is one that I've gotten had to get involved in personally a lot of times. Reading the solicitation packages very carefully and understanding the requirements and the deliverables. We typically go with the lowest bidder on a project. However, if the solicitation package isn't done completely to the standard, we can't go with the lowest. We have to essentially go with the lowest bidder that provides a complete package. And some of these things are very, very specific about what needs to take place and what needs to be in that package itself. So understanding those deliverables is really huge. You know, it's a shame sometimes when we are, by law, we're not able, I should say by the Federal Acquisition Regulation, the FAR, we're not able to turn a blind eye to a solicitation package or to a bid that isn't complete. So, you know, just really, really understand it and then ask questions. That's kind of the next one here. Refer to the solicitation regarding the submission of questions as well as contacting the POC listed. When in doubt, just contact that point of contact. You know, you don't want to do a lot of work preparing a great proposal and then, you know, have a technicality be the reason why your business wasn't selected. And then finally, provide your best price and proposal the first time. That's a huge one. You know, we try not to renegotiate as we go through. That's really not the way that the Corps does business. So make yourself competitive by providing your price and proposal up front, you know, in the process. Okay, so this is a very busy slide. What we'll make sure we do is to give you all a copy of this slide, just so that you have an idea of what it is that is on our horizon as the Nashville District, FY21, starting this October until next October. Again, I don't want to go into every single detail here, but we do have a lot of work going on here, you know, at all various different types of thresholds, really $100,000, or I'm sorry, $25,000, all the way up to really multi-million dollar projects. So again, we will continue to do our best to keep you informed of what opportunities are out there. We have a small business coordinator. Her name is Suzanne Nicholson. She is currently our small business coordinator. I think her point of contact is on the next page. But again, if you have any questions about what it is that we have on the horizon or anything like that, again, the next slide, I'll give you her points of contact. Okay? Yep, this is how you would be able to get in touch with Susan. And she would be able to give you any more detailed information about any of the projects that were listed on that previous slide.